We've discovered a new dinosaur, the dawn runner, Eodromaeus. Only about 3 or 4 feet long, and most of that is tail and neck, maybe 15 pounds maximum. It was a bipedal, two-legged predator. It chased down its prey, grabbed onto it with nice grasping hands, and munched on it with recurved teeth for slicing flesh. It is the best view we have of where the predatory lineage comes from, where they began. It began 230 million years ago in a beautiful scarred badlands today in the foothills of the Andes of Argentina. And we are announcing a complete new dinosaur, Eodromaeus. It has others alongside it. We discovered some of those years ago. Eoraptor, a small, we think a plant eater now, a small plant eater about the same size, and Herrerasaurus, a distant cousin as well. These are the earliest dinosaurs and our best view of what happened at the dawn of the dinosaur era. You know, a lot of the story that we're bringing to press today about Eodromaeus is told in the rocks around Eodromaeus. It's really a lot of hard work. We didn't just bag the dinosaur and run. No, we looked at the surrounds of the dinosaur, and then much beyond that. We went and crawled across this valley from top to bottom, logging every strata, looking for climate changes, collecting every animal we encountered so that we could ultimately say, here's a pie chart of the animals that were around in Eodromaeus' day. A couple million years later, because we actually radioisotopically dated these beds, we can say how much time was involved. What happened at dinosaur origins? That was our bigger question. Yes, we wanted to find new dinosaurs like Eodromaeus, Eoraptor, but ultimately the question is, what gave them the edge? Was it a simple competitive scenario where they were better, or was it more complicated? It was not a simple competitive advantage with dinosaurs becoming much more common. No, it was more complicated. So there were spins and turns at the early part of dinosaurs, and in the end of the day, at about 200 million years ago, after about 30 million years of occupying habitats with other animals, dinosaurs were on top. It was largely a lucky break, we think, but a lot of dinosaur evolution went into those first 30 million years. All the major groups, the major clades were formed during that time period. And that's really the story that emerges from our work. And it takes years to put that together, but it's great fun.